Hello everyone, Stardust King here, and welcome back to Gundam Battle Gunpla Warfare. Today we'll be taking a look at the Strike Noir. Okay, I'm going to show you where to get its parts first, because why not? Alright, you get the parts by trading in the new coin. It came with the event, the Aspidian coin. It comes with 7 parts: the head, the body, the arms, the legs, the backpack, dual sabers, and a pilot. You can also get the 5-star versions of the parts if you complete the achievements, because you will get a 5-star obsidian coin. You can use it to turn in and get one of these. You get the regular obsidian coins by doing the obsidian wings event. I'll be linking my event guide right here, potentially, who knows. So if you guys want to watch that, you know, it's a short and quick video, 15 minutes. I cover most of the basics in like the first 3 minutes, and the other like 15, or 12, it's just me trying to complete the event. Take a look at the achievements too while I'm here. As you can see, all the way down here, at 2500, you get the Obsidian coins, and you can also get the pilot if you get 65,000. It's gonna take a while. Maybe if I was farming this whole time, which I haven't, spoiler alert. But yeah, without further ado, let's actually take a look at the Gunpla. That's the reason why you're all here to begin with, right? The Strike Noir. All right, let's take a look. Let's see. Shot attack. Not really bad, TBH. Armor, melee attack, melee defense. Kind of lacking shot defenses, all right, I guess. Head mouth and Vulcans. You know, I don't really need to go over those. Majority of the whole few have them. Body. This is should, start us. I saw all the event mobile suits. Off camera, but I'll do this on camera. Let's see, armor is okay, shot defense is okay, melee attack, shot attack, melee defense, beam resistance, and it has no physical resistance. With dual saber categories, dual saber category puts EX skill damage output boosted by 20%. Let's see, there was like a percentage, but it's just a flat amount. I don't really see anything I would want to go for. That's no melee attack whatsoever. Shot attack, melee defense. Shot defense is okay. Armor's with speed attribute self, melee crit rate boosted to 17%. The effect is kind of okay, but I wouldn't go out of my way to get this part. I guess it's getting the 3-star treatment. Although we did have some really good 3-stars. So, Strike Noir. Fire the twin pistols on your legs. Cooldown 21 seconds first time, 3 seconds. Press A, power D, beam shot. You don't really go for legs or stats, depending on how well the EX skill performs. I may invest into that. Dual linear. Want to go back for you. Max out with space. Bombard enemies with dual rail guns. You can move while firing. Category, physical shot, pierce. D, power, B plus, magazine, 7, cooldown, 60 seconds, first time, 60 seconds. Well, first time, 0 seconds. Skills like that are inherently good, I guess, CBH. Especially if you're like on a backpack or legs, chest, parts that really don't really matter for the most part. Stat wise, I guess chest matters stat wise, but the legs and backpack really don't. I peeped these earlier. They're really bad. 12% chance attacks penetrating super armor. I wouldn't go for them. The only thing I would actually go for is the legs in the backpack in the pilot. That's my general recommendation. Sven Cal Bayang, Let's not go over that. Armor, melee attack, it's alright. Shot attack is a little bit low. Melee defense, shot defense are okay. Beam resistance and physical resistance are on the lower side, but that's okay. He has a good stat distribution overall compared to most pilots. And he comes with the Outfighter. Fight cell. Well, oh, yeah, pilot. Yeah, job license, there you go. That's what it's called. With speed attribute, initially he had skill charge boosted by 12%. Not bad, not bad. I like how I said I was going to start all these. I did not. Alright, kids. Okay, he doesn't come with a melee, a shield, or, what's his face? Or ranged weapon. Alright. We're almost done here, I guess. Alright, let's go to... let's go to the, let's do this. Wait, okay. Parts traits with dual sabers category equipped via skill damage output boosted by a flat amount. With speed attribute itself, melee crit rate boosted by a certain percent, a certain percent chance of attacking while attacks penetrating super armor. With speed attribute self, initially a skill charge boosted by a certain percent. Okay, not bad, not bad. You'll be getting Gundam type, Force Base, and 4 Tundra. You'll be getting 4 Force Bases, 6 Gundam types, and 3 4 Tundras. Maybe asking what those do? Well, I'll tell you. With Gundam type, raises armor 5% and physical resist 5% while active. For space, raises all parameters 1% while active. Space category gets an extra 3% boost. And high, you'll be getting 1 high mobility too. Raises shot defense and beam resist while active. 5% for Tundra. And for Tundra is the same thing as for space, but Tundra category gets an extra 3% boost. Alright. With that said, we're done here for the most part. However, just in case we get mollywopped, I don't want to get mollywopped, so I'm just going to put that on. Alright, so we're going to take a look at how it looks in all the colors. Actually, it looks rather nice in the Gundam colors, C8. But it loses all that mystique, you know? I don't think it's going to look too good in the other colors. Because with its color scheme, it really stands out, you know? The original one. But this one, it just looks like the other Gundams. I guess it really doesn't, kind of. But it sort of does. I don't understand what I mean. Sort of. I haven't seen really anything that pops by. Well, besides dual Gundam, because dual Gundam looks good on everything in the other one. Yeah, Hayuki Shiki. Welcome to the third guy, I am. That doesn't look too bad. That doesn't look too bad either. Okay. Doesn't look bad. And then anything looks good in these other two colors. Well, these other colors. Alright, Delta Plus. Actually doesn't look bad in Delta Plus. It's usually the head is like really black, but it's not anymore. No. Well, I like how it looks in this original colors. This real original color scheme is really good. Speaking of which, let's go get it, shall we? I will suggest buying one of every piece, like always, just so you can come into collections. Okay, Stargazer. Is he here? No, he's not here. I know where he's from. I don't know the name of it though. Shouldn't he be like here? No. Oh, he's not here. First Stargazer on the map. Just G. Z. Stargazer, oh, there it is. The Strike Noir. Hey, War. No, he got his box. He got his colors. I actually really do like this box art. It's rather nice. Modified version of the Strike. Wish we got the pistols to go along with it. Maybe one day in the future. Anyways, let's hop into a mission. And then we'll be on our way. Free mission. We're a little bit on the weaker side, so we're just gonna go back to our good friend 1-1. I still think they should add a what's face in there? An area to test out your skills, so you won't have to go through this. Nope, we're not gonna do the same thing we did the last time with the launcher strike launcher. Brought companion and they just molly walk people. Also, I'm gonna blow my nose for some. Ooh, I kinda like that. Ooh, that's nice. Dude. That does a ridiculous amount of damage. You know, we have these. Also, I kinda moved, so I'm gonna wait for a little bit. So I can look at it again. Let's see. We're just gonna wait. Wish we can unlock on for this guy. Do want to test two things? I want to test the beam rifle thing again. See how much actual range it has. For the dual linear things. But apparently, I think I'm still in range. So, does he do three of these? Oh, I guess not. He just does two. Okay. So, that was the showcase video. The legs aren't. I mean, they have their uses, I guess. I may put some points in them just in case. You never know. It has a fast cooldown, I know that. It does some decent damage, but the backpack, my god. Backpack will be overpowered. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure you like and subscribe. Tell it to worry though, but it's entirely up to you. And if you have any suggestions for future videos, just let me know in the comments. But until then, I'll see everyone on the next GBGW video. Whatever that may be.